My good friend Halima from H&H Living helped me actually decorate my house. It was so hard to find the balance between being such an eclectic person and trying to be minimalistic as well. Because you'll see that in my home, I love color. I'm a very colorful person. I mean, duh, I'm wearing red. And Halima had to sort of bring in the vibe I was going for. I wanted color, but I wanted the canvas to be white. And I just love what she came up with. It is beautiful. It is gorgeous. It is such a beautiful interpretation of who I am. So I'll be moving out of this home in about a month, and I'm moving to another home that is completely different from this. So before I moved, I thought I should show you what my home looks like, because you've always wanted to know, where do I get my furniture pieces, who did my house, what happened, all of that. So here is the plan. So this is a console we had to repurpose, and this console is actually from Mr. Price, and all my frames, all the picture frames you're gonna see in my home are from Zara. And actually, this was a bouquet of flowers that my brother got me, and Halima managed to dry it and do this for me. I mean, guys, come on. This is so beautiful. And a lot of my little trinkets, my balls and stuff, are usually from Block and Chisel and from Zara Home as well. So we just like to, I don't know, to play around with little things from everywhere. And down here, she used to have a Buddha for me, but then the Buddha broke, so we moved it, and you're gonna see it, but it looked so beautiful when it was together. And from here already, you can tell what kind of person lives here, and like, I mean, you can just tell, yeah, I like things. Drawers I got, and we actually upholstered it because it was brown, and we put these handles on it. It's like a crystal and gold. And we made it black as well, so the antique store actually did this for us. All of these, again, Block and Chisel, and this tortoise we got from walking around. A lot of my books are actually from Exclusive Books on Salon, of course, because guys, if you see the price, it is insane, okay? And then this mirror is from a store in Rivonia. I also got this green marbled table, and you see a lot of candle collections. Usually these are covered, like, I am asthmatic, and all these candles, even though they smell amazing, guys, they just drive me nuts. Like, I sneeze, like, I block, and no. So usually they're covered, but of course, for today, we open them up and the house smells amazing. Yeah, we get these candles from Apsley House, and it's a, they have a home decor section, and that's where we get them from. So my couches, everybody wants to know, where are the couches from? So I got these couches from Wayland. Something bright and nice to go with my paintings. And so I was like, what would you suggest? So we picked out these colors. This is like a fuchsia. We kept the leather because, you know, when I play with that, I would like murder you. So we kept the white leather. And then we did everything else in this fuchsia pink. I don't know, what would you call this blue though? It's like a blue, okay? Let's just say that it's blue. And everything is velvet because I love velvet and things that feel velvety. It's just soft, it's easy to clean, and it's easy to just maintain. And then in these pillows, it's actually feather pillows, also from H&H Home. And they just feel so comfortable. I mean, feathers, they can like go like this and then go. So I just really like these pillows as well, the mustard and all of that, just keeping up with the colors that I wanted. And then this table has quite a story, guys. So we went to this random market, like a craft market by William Nicole, and then we found this root there, this one, and we said to the guy, can you just fix it for us and like fix it up and then bring it to us. So we bought the root separately and then we bought the glass separately. I think the cost for both together was under or just about 10,000 rand. And there's a company, I can't remember the name of the glass people, but we'll find out. And then the guy with the root, he's just on William Nicole, and we put it together. But in the store, we saw this and that inspired us. Do you want to know how much this table was, guys? 72,000 rand. 72. Like, who's gonna fuck that up? No. The table is also put together. It's like very simple. The layout is kept very minimal because I like a lot of little things. And this is what my interior decorator complains about, is that I like too many little things. Just took a random server and turned it into a TV stand. This server is from At Home, and in here I put all my extra plates, extra serving stuff when I'm hosting people, because I've got like a lot of things. And then I just have some more family pictures and my broken Buddha. My heart is so sore. And my broken Buddha is here, so I hope that, you know, Halima can help me find another one, even though we've seen a lot of other beautiful options. And my favorite corner in the house, which you've seen the most on Instagram, is right here. Like, this is from Block and Chisel, also velvet. We wanted it to go with the blue couch. And then we have this, let me just move that. So we have this beautiful turquoise vase that is keeping all my, what is this again, this day? Pompous grass. And just keeping it there. And this is my favorite corner in the house because it just looks so peaceful, and I don't know, there's just something about it here. Think about this home, I absolutely love is the marble counters, the marble everything. And that's the reason why I actually took it, is the white cupboards, marble, all of this. And then they have all these drawers here at the back that I really, really enjoy using. And this is my favorite space. I think you guys have seen me film so much in here. I mean, you guys know this place more than anything else in my home. And I'm an avid tea drinker. And you see it right here. I have like my collection of teas, my little ritual of tea things happening here. And you see, this is a random pot I got from like a Chinese store that I really like. And just little things that make me be happy, my birthday card, you know. That's what Halima means by having too many little things. And then another spot in the kitchen I like is this collection of little green and black stuff I really like. These are all from H&M Home, even the green chopping board or whatever you can call that. And then this is from At Home, and I usually keep like little sweets in here. You know, randomly, they're sugar free, okay? And then let's go to the next room. So this is where the magic happens, the YouTube magic. This is where I film. One thing I love about this home, you're gonna see they all come with these dressing tables, and it was so convenient for me to just pack up all my makeup right here. So when I'm filming, this is what you see in the background. It's my makeup collection and all of that stuff, my brushes, all of that. This is just mess I'm trying to put together, all the shopping I'm not open, blah blah blah. And then my equipment is here, my beers are right there, and just the stuff that I need. I just dump things in here, guys. Like, this is like my dumping room. This space has been so good to me because I've had space to create. I've had space to sort of be comfortable and close the door and just be in my own world by myself. And then in here, you don't want to see, okay? Not right now, but it's mostly shoes and just stuff that I just put in there. But this is my filming room, and it can shift so much. Like, we do so much with this room, and sometimes we work in here, sometimes we just hang out in here or whatever, but mostly what happens in here is the filming. And I have this drawer, chest of drawer that was made for me. I actually found these guys on Facebook, and I wanted 6 because I have a lot of stuff. Like, ugh. Guys, I'm not minimalist, I'm a maximalist. So in here there's just a lot of stuff. And then I love this thing. I don't know, it's like a globe thing with that gold inside. I love gold, I love white and colors, so I just love this thing. Every time I look into it, I sort of like get transported or something, I don't know. And my house has 3 bedrooms, and each bedroom has its own bathroom. Absolutely gonna miss about this house is the convenience of the bathrooms in the rooms like this. I have a small little corridor, and then I have a pantry right here. This pantry has food, it's got linen, it's got candles, so all sorts of things in it. Because it's also organized right now, we're not gonna show it to you, but we are gonna have organization videos coming up, but for my new home, and then we're gonna show that experience with you. This is my guest room, and this room has always been simple. They sleep, they go. That is the plan. There's no comfort. What? It is comfortable, but they sleep, they go, and go away. I currently have a guest in my home, so I can't really show you much of this one. But this is what basically it looks like. I picked up this painting, this one, at the beach in Mozambique on holiday, and then I just got it framed like this. And actually, Halima was saying that maybe we should put a white frame around it as well. And yeah, I love this. It's something that I will find very hard to part with if someone ever asked me to part with it. Last but not least is, you know, where the beauty sleep happens, because look at me. This is my bedroom. One thing I absolutely love about this room are all these wardrobes. Like, I have big, deep wardrobes, and they're fantastic for somebody who shops as much as I do and who has them as much as I do. And like I said before, another thing that I absolutely love about this home are the dressing tables. This has been absolutely convenient for me because I just wanna not stress about buying a table that I make a dressing table. I don't know if you get what I mean. So this has been perfect to have. It's got drawers where I keep all sorts of things like my combs, and that's just amazing. And don't ask me about that. You guys have asked me so many times, why have I never filled these frames? Please. I have no idea. Another chest of drawers I got from the same place in Rivonia that I told you about. I also got this from him. He was selling these in pairs, but I only took one. I don't know why I only took one. Also got these pillows from him, and they also have feathers inside as well. And on my bed, I sort of do feather, and then foam. And I can't remember the name of all the stores that I go to buy my bedding. This is from Mozambique. This is also from Mozambique, I think. But yeah, Mozambique. And then I love how she's put these pompous leaves here. This chest of drawer is from At Home, and it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 drawers, but they're very like slim, they're not like really deep. So I think that next time I look for something, I want it a bit more deeper. Curtains are another highlight in my room. We actually went to pick this up together, and then she made them for me. Guys, go check out H&H Living. You will thank me later because she makes amazing stuff. She also made this voile for my room. At least she wanted something neutral, something that's not too loud, because I was like, my whole house is loud. Do I really want my room to be loud? And we're like, then we're gonna go to my bathroom. Now guys, remember, I don't really live in like a gallery-ish feeling home. It's like a home. I like that because I like rustic stuff. So my bathroom, on my sink, you'll see that I actually use it. Where I film all the skincare stuff, like when you see me filming, this is where I film it. So one thing I'm not gonna miss about this bathroom, the bathtub. It is tiny, guys. Like, I can't put my whole body in it. And I think that where I'm moving to, I'm actually choosing it for the kitchen and the bathtub. This bathtub is really small, but what I like about this bathroom is that it's like a, like you use it and you go, you know? And I also have a life like that, which I hope to change next year. I really, really hope that I'm more at home and a bit more settled in than I have been in the past couple of years, because I have this big home and I don't really use it to its full potential. I have this little thing I got from Leroy Merlin, where I just put my stuff. I love this basket. I don't remember where I got this basket from, but I put my towels in there because you guys have also asked me where I got it from. Guys, these two paintings, if I tell you the story of these two paintings, you're gonna be shook at it. But I love these, and these are what always inspire my home. I've moved with them, I think since 2014, 2015. I've always had them. They were not always framed like this, but then we got them framed like this to make them look a bit more sophisticated and all of that. But these paintings are what we usually center our home around. You're gonna see the process that Halima is gonna use our H&H home for decorating my next home. And then you're gonna see how she's gonna use this as the inspiration to sort of decorate the entire home. That's the journey, because what you've seen in here today is not what's gonna be in my next home. And that's why I felt like kind of okay to show it to you, because I was like, it's not gonna be the same. It's gonna be completely different. So then you get to see that later. So this balcony is much smaller than where we're going to. Something that I like about this is this tree. This tree has always been like the feng shui-ness of the home, if I could say. And the tree just makes it absolutely beautiful. And I like to eat al fresco. I like to eat outside. And then just eating, sitting here with my family and my friends and eating has always been so peaceful. And I have a whole little zen garden thing going on over here. This actually I got from Loads of Living. It's a Moroccan inspired candle holder lamp thingy situation. I just love how she put it on the table. So guys, I just want to tell you a little bit about this carpet. It took us such a long time to find an appropriate carpet to go with the couch and everything that I have in the home. But this couch is perfect. I don't remember again the name of the store, but this store is somewhere in Pine Slopes. And it's somebody from Pakistan, and he has a beautiful carpet store. And the idea is that what you see on this side isn't exactly what you see on the other side. So it was neutral enough for us to put it in the home with the couches and everything, without the carpet being loud. But then the carpet is also something you pay attention to. This is it. And I can't wait to show you the next project. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna film that house empty. And then we're gonna show it to you when it's decorated. And then we're gonna also share the experience of finding everything that we're gonna make and everything that we're gonna use to decorate it. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I've finally shown you my home and shown you what is in it. So I hope you enjoy this. Give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to give a follow to H&H. And then don't forget to check out the description box so that you get all the information that you need. I love you guys. See you in the next video. Ciao.